At Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory, we have a mission of national security and to do science in the interest of national security. Now, these are very challenging, complex problems, and it requires a multidisciplinary team to come together and solve those. CASC, or the Center for Applied Scientific Computing, is a research organization of approximately 125 mostly PhDs in applied mathematics, computer science, data science, and computational physics. And those different fields can work together and help devise new solutions to the problems we face. Today, we are forging new directions in the work that we do, primarily in high-performance scientific computing, with the merger of traditional simulation techniques with data science techniques.
Anthem is one of several long-term projects in CASC where we are focusing on research in advanced hardware finite element discretizations and applications of hardware methods. One of the reasons this research is interesting and challenging is because Anthem is a library that is trying to impact many applications. And so even if you know how to perform adaptive mesh refinement or have a very good preconditioner for a particular application that takes advantage of application information, when you provide these methods as part of a library for many users, you need to be much more robust, much more scalable, and much more general. The open source SW4 code developed in CASC models hyperbolic wave propagation using advanced fourth order finite difference scheme based on summation by part principles. SW4 has been used to perform regional earthquake simulations of the San Francisco Bay Area at unprecedented 10 Hertz resolution. This type of simulations require hundreds of billions of grid points, and by using GPU acceleration, SW4 has been able to run this type of problems much faster and at much higher resolution on Livermore Sierra supercomputer than on the previous generations of CPU-only machines.
Another way we're trying to address this high degree of concurrency, having to make use of all these various processors simultaneously, is to look at new concepts like parallelization in time.
Parallel and time methods have recently become very popular because with the increasing size of supercomputers, which require more parallelism than ever, it has become necessary to find other ways of generating parallelism versus just in space as we have done so far. So what we do here, since we are experts in multigrid methods, we actually find ways to apply a multi-level idea to the time dimension. The problem here is flow around a cylinder. So on the left you see what happens when you use a traditional time-stepping method, and on the right you see the parallel in time method. You can already see some of the vortexes developing much earlier, and we're done within 5 iteration steps, where the left side is still going.
When I started at the lab, CASC had gotten funding to study solver technology for deterministic transport. And that was really great, because what that turned into was this huge body of research that has lasted a decade that's actually proven that these sweep algorithms, we can find ways to make them scale really well. And what that's allowed us to do is, it basically was our solution for scalable algorithms on Sequoia, and it created a template for us to develop solutions and solver technology for Sierra. We now have a new LDRD project that's studying transport on using high-order finite element methods. And so that, again, is a collaborative effort between CASC and my organization. It's led by CASC to deliver transport solutions on really strange-looking meshes. And so that's pretty exciting, too. So we're starting the whole cycle over again of this very collaborative group of people that has a focus on a programmatically relevant problem that we're researching across the board.
In CASC, we have a long history of breaking new ground by devising new algorithms and applying those to these national security problems. Today, we're continuing that tradition of groundbreaking algorithms by looking at a new way of doing simulation, something we call cognitive simulation.
One good example of the new approach of marrying experimental and simulation capability is the Pilot 2 effort, part of the cancer moonshot initially instigated by then Vice President Biden. We were trying to understand the role of the RAS protein in the cancer chain. So at Livermore, we are doing simulations where we can observe the RAS protein in detail, and then using machine learning techniques to do the multi-scale modeling necessary to do so over long periods of time and for large enough pieces of the cell membrane to be experimentally relevant, And then we take the results that we get from the machine learning and actually give them to our colleagues at Frederick National Lab, where they're actually growing these cell membranes, putting RAS molecules on it, and then running experiments with that membrane to see how well our simulations agree with their experimental results, for ultimately the entire community to get a better insight into what activates RAS, how does the signaling chain work, and what could we do to potentially interrupt the signaling for mutated RAS that are involved in a lot of cancer types.
The challenges of high-performance computing are only going to get more difficult moving forward as computers substantially change and Moore's Law comes to an end. CASC is well positioned to address those challenges in the future, and it's really exciting to be part of that mission that has a real meaning, where we know we're making an impact for the national security and also to the greater scientific community.